I want to talk about how do I become a candidate magnet. Your online presence is everything. And what we don't know is how do people search for us before they ever contact us? What happens from the moment they sit down at their computer to the moment they fill out an application and find you as a potential employer? So let's talk about how do we become a magnet to these great top talents. First of all, we're not findable at all. We haven't thought about what does our online presence look like before we ever speak to them. The tables have turned. The prospects, the candidates, are in control. They get to decide who they're going to work with, not us. They get to make first impressions. They get to judge. So we need to understand by which mediums are they checking us out. And then finally, I'm going to give you some very specific strategies that you can immediately implement to be a top candidate magnet in your space. So let me introduce you to Aaron. Aaron is the largest manufacturer of bamboo toothpicks in the US. Woohoo! Exciting, right? Have you guys ever been to the bar? And they put those really fancy little knotted toothpicks in your drink with like the olives in it. That increases the price of that drink by $2. $2 just for the toothpick. So let's have more toothpicks, shall we? So when we looked at this, Aaron had a really big problem between pick and toothpick. They called their entire website pick. Now, what do you think is wrong with the word pick on us? Yeah, bullying websites. They were ranking for bullying websites. Remember, this is a toothpick manufacturing company, okay? So here's part of that problem is they never Googled the word pick. Well, we have guitar picks, we've got mining picks, and you'll see here, you can see Fender, Gibson, Dunlap. These are all the categories that are directly related to that concept. So you see how that phrase disconnected them to a huge amount of search volume because they were too much in their marketing head. They're like, we're not toothpicks, we are picks. And that made them instantly unfindable and ranking for bullying websites. So we had to just reveal this to them. This is what they do. Knotted bamboo toothpicks, right? Seems pretty obvious. But they had never used the word toothpick on their website ever. They had only used the word pick. So, and what now you'll see that that's their toothpicks, that's their toothpicks, that's their tooth. All of these have been strategically optimized. Each image has been named how I want it to be findable. Not image1.jpg, image2.jpg, image3.jpg, right? I'm going to say best knotted bamboo toothpick on the planet.jpg, okay? I'm going to name each one of the images on my website strategically so that each one gets pulled and placed into search results. And just like for your company, you can take those images and slowly start to craft an image plan. And that image plan is going to be, how do we want to be findable to the best candidates? What are the best pictures that we have that we can make sure they rank here so that we're not just using our language, we're using their language. We're not using picks, we're using bamboo toothpicks. Okay? We have to make sure that we're using the language of our candidates. We have to be prepared. As HR professionals, we need to have our, what I call, findable house in order. We know exactly what comes up under our company name. We know what comes up under images. And we've optimized those images so we craft everything that shows up there. And then, of course, we have video. Think about the video you currently have in your YouTube channel. How can we leverage that video to be a great reflection of what's it like to work at your amazing organization? And then, of course, we have Yelp. Like it or not, Yelp is a very big option. Now, even if you don't have a walk-in presence, you're not a restaurant, Yelp ranks. So for me, in my findable world, I use every single tool at my disposal. Yelp will rank right under your name. So if I have a chance to start thinking about, here's my search results. How can I make 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and all of those search results exactly what I want? You have control to do this. But what I find is that most marketing teams and IT teams are so interested in the robot of Google that they forget about the human side of a job search. And if I Google you, I hear your name. Someone says, that's an amazing place to work. I'm going to Google it. And what I see right there in search results is gold for you. You need to make sure that each one of those results is the very best representation of your brand. If it's not, that candidate's going to move on.